The row over the ownership of Migingo Island has put citizens of Kenya and Uganda at loggerheads. And following a myriad of accusations, including that Uganda had sent its army to take charge of the island, government spokesmen from both countries were in Nairobi, ostensibly to clear the air.
There's no military in the proximity, Uganda military in the proximity of Migingo Island.
After consultations between security chiefs from both countries, Uganda will remain in charge of the island.
As other security arrangements are explored, law and order in the Migingo Island is being overseen by Uganda Police, headed by the Assistant Superintendent of Police.
It's until the demarcation, then security will thereafter be provided by the sovereign power within whose jurisdiction the island will be situated after the demarcation.
The Ugandan flag will continue to fly high on the island, but Opolot maintains that it will be hoisted because of the presence of a police post. Surveyors from both countries have already embarked on determining the boundaries between the two countries.
Within the agreement or the protocol signed was that we fast track the survey and we pay half-half. Uganda pays 50% and we pay 50% of the cost of the boundary. It is estimated to be about 130 to 140. A million Kenya shillings.
However, the exercise continues against a backdrop of claims of harassment of Kenyan fishermen on the island.
As we speak now, 20 fishermen have gone missing. It is believed that they have been abducted by Ugandan military officers who have taken over Migingo.
No arrests have been made and no one has been harassed.
Whether the claims are true or not, Kenyans will have to wait for the outcome of the work of the surveyors to know whether they are on the island legally or illegally. Franklin Masharia, Citizen TV.